السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصيكم أولا ونفسي بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون. قال تعالى في كتابه: أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو حماصا وتروح بطانا، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. الحمد لله، all praise and thanks due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Peace and salawat upon our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers and elders in Islam, firstly I would like to advise myself and those who are present, ittaqillaha ta'ala, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, at all moments. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in a very perfect manner. The most superior, the most honored creation in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah says in the Quran, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Verily, most surely, we have honored son of Adam. We have carried him above land and above ocean. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah says in the Quran, in another place, هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. There was a time in our life, or there was a time with regard to insaniya, human race, there was a period. Allah is asking, has not the time has passed upon you? لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. This human was something which cannot be mentioned, or he was not existing. There was nothing. لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. And then Allah says, إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة نمشاج. And we brought this human race into existence from a drop of sperm. Such a perfect creation was created. But there was a period that cannot be mentioned or cannot be spoken about, when he was a drop of sperm. My dear brothers in Islam, before we were not existing, Allah Ta'ala made us exist. Allah has made us perfect. Allah has made us look perfect. Quran, when we look further, Allah says, وَلَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقًا فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغًا فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحْمًا ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. Allah says, how we created this human, this superior, supreme, honored creation, from a drop of stone turned into a blood clot in the womb of the mother, an angel was appointed to take care of that blood clot, and then it turned into a piece of flesh, then the bones, then the skin, and everything was created. فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. All praise to Allah, the best of creators. Thereafter Allah says, ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون. Allah says, after we create this insan as a perfect creation, the next stage, the next level is death in the life of this human. My dear brothers in Islam, will it end with death? Will it conclude with death? No, it is the beginning. The day the insan leaves this world as unmayyit, that is the beginning of reality in his life. That's why Allah says, ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبْعَثُونَ. He was nowhere, he was nothing, and then he became a hero. He thought the world is within him, the world is within his control, and then the death overpowers him, he becomes zero and nowhere. And thereafter, Allah says, we shall resurrect him again. We shall bring him back into reality again. That is the day of Qiyamah, that we shall be resurrected in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers in Islam, that is the reality of our life. That is the haqiqa and the truth. The life that we live today, it's not the reality. Today we live in this world, the way our mind, our heart, our intelligence, our intellectuality guiding us. Let us remember, my dear brothers in Islam, we have not been created in vain. We have not been sent to this world just to pass time and to move on. But Allah says, we created you, you were nothing, then we made you a perfect human, we gave you life, we adorned you, we gave you everything. Now that Allah is asking, أَفَحَسِبُتُمْ مَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا. Ayah which is shocking to you and me. This ayah carries two parts. أَفَحَسِبُتُمْ مَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا. Do you think? Do you think that we have created you in vain? In vain? Without a purpose in life? Without an objective in life? And further Allah is asking, وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. This is what we discussed just now, that you shall not return to us. There are two parts, the life that we live in this world and the life that we are going to live hereafter. My dear brothers in Islam, this is what that we have forgotten or neglected, that the journey of Akhirah, it is known as Yawmul Qiyamah, the day. What does it mean by the word Yawmul Qiyamah? The day that all will be present. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَ يَكُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It is the day that entire human race entire creation, human, jinnas, angels, all the creation will be made to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in front of our Maker, in front of our Creator. My dear brothers in Islam, that's why it is known as Yawmul Qiyamah. Let us understand, for us, we may define days as important days in our life. The day we got married, the day I started working, or the day I graduated from school, or the day I graduated from the university, the day I started my business, the day I was born, the first day my first child was born, and etc. We consider these days to be great days in our life. No, my dear brothers in Islam, the greatest day in our life, the greatest day in our life, it is the day that we are made to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just imagine. Allah says in the Quran, Allahu la ilaha illa hu, la yajma'annakum ila yawmi al-qiyamati la rayba fihi. O people, there is none worthy of worship but Allah. La yajma'annakum ila yawmi al-qiyamah. That entire human being, from the first Nabiuna Adam to the last child ever born on this planet, will be made to stand in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La rayba fi, there is no doubt in that. My dear brothers in Islam, that is the greatest day in our life. That is the most powerful day. My dear brothers in Islam, we need to ask today, we need to prepare ourselves today for that day that we are made to stand in front of Allah. When we study the Quran, more than 70 places, Allah speaks about this day. The word Yawmul Qiyamah is repeated. Quran is warning you and me, reminding you and me of this day that we shall return to Allah, that we shall be made to stand in front of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, do we know the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Qiyamah will occur in the day of Jumu'ah. It comes in some narration. The entire creation of Allah waits on this day to see from which direction the sun is rising. It is so serious. And another name for the Yawmul Qiyamah, Yawmul Ashhad, a day that we will be made to witness. Our actions will be presented, our deeds will be presented in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers, elders in Islam, when we look into the Quran, there are many names are given to this day. As As-Sa'a, yas'alunaka 'anis-sa'a, they ask, when is the hour, the real hour, the real time, the real moment that you and me will be made to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell these people, min amri rabbi, it is from the knowledge of Allah. Nobody has been given this knowledge. Those who predict in the past, many false prophets or many individuals were predicting And they say the world will end 2008, 9, 10, millennium, and etc., etc. But my dear brothers in Islam, it will hatta idha ja'athum as-sa'atu baghtatan, qiyama will occur suddenly, without no creation on this planet got the knowledge. When Jibril alayhi salatu wa salam met Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked, matas-sa'a, when is the qiyama? When, what date the Qiyamah will occur? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, mal mas'oolu anha bi'a'lama min as-sa'il. The person who is asking should have this knowledge than the person who has been questioned. It means, if me as Rasul do not have, you as Jibreel will not have that information. My dear brothers in Islam, a day awaits you and me. A day is definite and confirmed. My dear brothers in Islam, when we go further into the Quran, Allah specifies this day. وَأَنذِرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْحَسْرَةِ إِذِ الْقُلُوبُ لَدَى الْحَنَاجِرِ. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah is saying, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, warn your ummah about the day of hasra, the day of regret. My dear brothers in Islam, it is the day doers of good will enjoy, doers of good deeds will be happy, doers of amal salihah will enjoy, and they will be safe from the agony of that day. But there are people known as Yawmul Hasra, in agony, in worry, crying, feeling sad. My dear brothers in Islam, commentators of the Quran go to this degree that in the day of Qiyamah, those who mock at Islam will cry. Even in the Quran, Allah speaks about people who are mocking at Islam, mocking at the teaching, looking down on Islam and this deen, and they will cry, why this hidayah did not come to us? Why this guidance did not come to us? Every person, even a person who was doing a'mal salihah, a person come visit the masjid for salatul fara'id, he will cry on that day, I would have made my sunnah before, I would have come to the masjid little earlier. A person who makes salatul fajr will cry on that day, I would have made my salatul tahajjud. A person, my dear brothers in Islam, whatever good deed that he or she was doing in the lifetime, will cry on that day, they would have done something better and more a'mal salihah. That's why Quran names this day of Qiyamah as Yawmul Hasra, a day of agony. Not only that, when we go further in the Quran, today, my dear brothers in Islam, many live the life the way they want, the way they wish. They do not make sure what is halal, what is haram, what is in the obedience of Allah, what is in the disobedience of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, as we all know, behind all sin, evil and crime is Shaytan, the Iblis. In that day, my dear brothers in Islam, when he sees the azab and the punishment of Allah is coming, Shaytan, the Iblis and his army will start running. And my dear brothers in Islam, Allah says in the Quran, this cry, the sadness, agony, the pain will become even worse when they are entered into Jahannam, and this Iblis will come and he will look at them and he will tell them, Subhanallah, Inna Allah وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم وما كان لي عليكم سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي. My dear brothers in Islam, that
in that day, this Iblis will visit his own friends who are friends with him in this world, and he will say, Allah made a promise, I made a promise, فَأَخْلَقْتُكُمْ, but I have to break the promise under this situation. وَمَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. O people, I had no control over you, I did not control you, إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ, I gave you a beautiful invitation, you accepted my invitation. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنْفُسَكُمْ, do not blame me, blame your own self, and I will not be able to help you, neither you shall be able to help me on this day of agony and difficulty. My dear brothers in Islam, commentators of the Quran, they say, this will be the most painful moment to doers of sin and evil in the day of Qiyamah. Then they will start crying, لَوَنَّ لِي كَرَّا, can I have another opportunity in this world? I'll break off from all these type of evil relationships, friendship, and I'll be in the obedience of my Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, لا يستقدمون ولا يستغفرون. If you look into the Quran, no time will be adjusted to this human. The time that we have, let us prepare for that star, for that moment, that we shall be made to stand in front of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, many lived in this world, many are living, many, all of us will leave from this world one day. What are we going to take in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let us ask, my dear brothers in Islam, today, matters which are life, we have made it so serious. Example, marriage, a matter which is very light in the light of Islam, very simple in the light of Islam, but we have made it very, very difficult and burden upon ourselves. With regard to our livelihood, with regard to everything in this world, minor things, we made it major in our lives. My dear respected brothers, elders in Islam, the major thing is the day of Qiyamah, that we shall be made to stand in front of Allah. Every person will be drowning in his own sweat. The sun will be brought closer, 1 mile away, or few distance away, it will be brought. And people will be drowning and crying and in agony and difficulty. My dear brothers in Islam, all the ummah that Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. In that day, it carries so much of agony. A person will run away from his blood brother, from his friend. Husband will run away from the wife. Wife will run away from the husband. The mother will run away from the child. The child will run away from the mother. A beautiful narration, my dear brothers in Islam. A shocking message to you and me. In that day, the mother will come to the son. The mother will come to the son. And she will tell the son, oh my son, oh my beloved son, give me one hasana, one good deed. That's all I ask you. And she will remind the good that she has done throughout her life. I carried you, I gave birth to you, I did this to you, I did that to you. Son will say, oh my mother, I know you did all these things to me. But today, if you can, you give me one good deed. Subhanallah. My dear brothers in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, in that day, people will be hufatan, uratan, ghuruba. People will be barefooted, naked, uncircumcised, how they were created, awwal marra, the very first time, that's how they will stand in front of Allah. Aisha radiallahu anha asked, Ya Rasulullah, people will start looking at each other, Ya Rasulullah.
رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم say, الأمر أهم من ذلك أو أشد من ذلك يا عائشة. Oh my wife, oh my beloved wife, the difficulty and the agony and the worry is much worse than that. A person complains of a headache. Now he sees a snake in front of him. He will forget his headache. This is the situation that even though that we will be made to stand in that manner, the worry and the fear and the condition in that day, my dear brothers in Islam, much worse than that. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ. Allah says in the Quran, O people, fear that hour, that moment that we shall be made to stand in front of Allah. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. The quake of that day, the zalzala of that day, something very, very great. There will be a quake and an earthquake on that day. According to the commentators of the Quran, it will begin by the heart. People will be confused to see what is happening around them. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah says, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on that day, you will see your ummah, you will see people will be confused to that degree. Every suckling mother, every mother who suckles her own child will throw her child. وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. Every pregnant mother will lose her pregnancy. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى. You will see people intoxicated. وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى. They are not intoxicated. وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. But the torment and the punishment of that day is so great, they look as that they are confused. My dear brothers in Islam, the day Allah appointed the angel to blow the trumpet, it comes in the hadith that angel of Allah looking towards the heaven and waiting for instruction. He has lifted the trumpet, made it close to his mouth. His eyes are looking towards the heaven, waiting for the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is so close. وَمَا أَمْرُ السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ. The hour, the qiyamah is so close. It is closer than the winking of an eye. Subhanallah. Do we need any further commentary on this? My dear brothers in Islam, we live a life thinking that we're going to live too long and Qiyamah will not occur so quick. But Quran is saying it is closer than winking of an eye. My dear respected brothers, elders in Islam, such a painful day. We have taken it very light in our life. The younger generation thinks, I need to become old and then the Qiyamah will come. And a person in the middle age thinks, I need to become old and the Qiyamah will come. No, my dear brothers in Islam, it will occur baghtatan. My dear brothers in Islam, I was requested by the masjid to speak in detail about the Yawmul Qiyamah. Today we are having an introduction amongst ourselves. This will go inshallah in detail continuously. Whatever we have spoken, it is very little of the introduction. Let us understand
that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam detailed everything. He did not leave us in darkness. He did not leave us without any knowledge. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave all details, all information, all guidance, how it will happen, when it will happen, what manner it will happen, before it happens, what are the signs, what are the minor signs, what are the major signs. When you see it is happening, it is a sign of Qiyamah. My dear brothers in Islam, inshallah, the coming, we shall discuss the signs of Qiyamah in detail, in depth, in order that we have no excuse in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran and the Sunnah had spoken in detail. When we take any book of hadith, all the books of ahadith are filled with the narrations of the hour and the Qiyamah. My dear brothers in Islam, for our information, whatever the signs Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke as minor signs, all of them have appeared. All of them have appeared. Not one left from the minor signs. All of them have come out. One of the very first times, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ana wa sa'a kahatayn, me and our are very close. My coming as the last Rasul to this Ummah itself is an indication that Qiyamah had neared. Qiyamah is nearing. My dear brothers in Islam, let us ponder over matters, trivial matters, we break our brains, we break our heads. But Qiyamah is something very serious, a day that no one with us but ourselves. And we need the rahmah and the refuge and the help of Allah. Let us do good amal salihah. It is nearing. Even the situation that we see around our country today, so much of hate campaign against Allah and Rasul, against Muslims, against the Quran, against the teachings of Islam, these are all minor signs of Qiyamah. When we see, we should say, Sadaqa Rasulullah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has spoken the truth. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it will become worse. It will become worse. And then a time will come. Allah will raise Islam when the time of the arrival of Isa and Mahdi alayhi salatu wa salam. My dear brothers in Islam, these are the times that we as a ummah crossing, we as a small nation crossing in this whole land, let us look at them and get close to Allah. Get build our nearness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are indications that world is aging, world is coming to an end, the time is coming to an end, the hour is coming to an end, the months are coming to an end, the years are coming to an end. With the destruction of this world, my dear brothers in Islam, we shall talk in detail inshallah, subhanallah, that even the scientists are studying, they took the bait from Islam. They know what may happen, what will come, what will fall upon this mankind, what are the disasters, destructions happening, whatever the earthquake, simple, we hear every time there is a quake, there is that disaster, this disaster, these are all alamatum min alamatis sa'ah, all signs, an indication that time is nearing. World is aging, the dunya is coming to an end, and the real world is advancing, the akhirah is advancing towards each one of us. My dear brothers in Islam, let us look at these things, take heed. Today, a person has some sickness, and a cough, a fever, and whatever some signs appear, we are worried. We are shocked, we are running towards the doctor, and we see in our business some problems that we are foreseeing, this may happen due to this condition. We are running, we are taking advice, we are taking guidance. My dear brothers in Islam, all these signs are saying that the world is coming to an end, but we still forgetful. We are missing our fara'id. May Allah save you and me. We are missing the teachings of Allah. We are still neglecting the order of Allah. We are still bold enough to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us realize, make us understand, and give us the realization to prepare ourselves for this great day and to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while sitting in those beautiful chairs and pulpits made out of pearls, emeralds and gold. And they are the most fortunate people, spend their lives in the obedience of Allah. They did whatever they could to contribute and to support the beautiful deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know today there is one institution is here. Institution of this mahalla, of this masjid, surrounding this masjid, as long as there is ta'lim and ta'allum, when there is teaching of Quran and Sunnah, the punishment of Allah will not come down. That's why all the creations on this planet making dua to Mu'allimin Nas al-Khair, for that person who is teaching good, for those people who are learning and teaching the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hatta al-Isanu fil ma, even the fish in the ocean making dua for a student of ilm and for a teacher. Why, my dear brothers in Islam? When it is not happening, the punishment of Allah will come down. When it comes, and all around will be destroyed. That is the reason, my dear brothers in Islam, every locality, every masjid should have this practice. Alhamdulillah, in Kirlapan area, there is a religious institution. They are teaching the Quran and the Sunnah, and many ulama and kuffaz were produced. Outstanding ulama and kuffaz were produced. My dear brothers in Islam, whatever we could support, whatever we could contribute, let us do that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order that will remain for us tomorrow in the day of Qiyamah, when we are made to stand in front of Allah. Whatever we have spoken, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala